What's up, guys? So today we're gonna go over making a jacket. This jacket is very special leather. It was told to me by a peer of mine who makes shoes, great artisanal shoes. His name's James Kearns. I'll have a link to his shoes for sure. If you're into artisanal shoes, check him out. He does everything himself. He's a one-man show, an absolute beast. Highly suggest. Anyway, so let me know about this leather. It was a cool horse alternative to what we had been using. And for garments, we have to split the leather, basically make it thinner so it can go through the machines. Garments need to be much thinner than shoes because of the way that the body moves. If it's super thick, you always hear me talking about that, it's going to be difficult to get through the machines and it'll be difficult to wear, it's not going to feel good. So anyways, that being said, here's the final product. The jacket's here. This is it. Basically, it was extremely difficult, so I had to do some things a bit differently. This is fully a one-of-a-kind garment. I don't even know if I'd ever make it again, just because it was so difficult to make. There's areas that are really thin, and there's areas that are like super thick. And you'll see it in the video right here, super thick. But anyways, I love the outcome. The jacket is super cool, very unique. I left all the threads. It's kind of a motif of mine. I've been doing it for a long time, or since I was in school. My teachers used to tell me that it's something that you shouldn't be doing, but I kept it going, and it's kind of become my thing. But anyways, I love all the imperfections. I love all the scars. I love like everything that tells the story of an animal throughout its life. And you know, this leather really shows that. I wish it could get split a little more uniform. That's okay. I love it just the way it is. Just don't know if I'd do it again. So today's gonna be a lot of time lapse. You're gonna see just a lot of like just time lapse. And you know, I hope you enjoy what you guys see. If you have any notes or suggestions or helpful critique, let me know. But that being said, here we go. All right, thanks guys, I hope you enjoy it. What's up, guys? So yesterday, ran into some issues. Leather was super thick, muscling through it. That's all right. Mainly on the Adler here, which is basically, as I always call it, my bazooka. But still, it does have some issues when like closing up garments and finishing them. Certain areas where you have top stitching going to one direction, or two areas of top stitch that are intersecting, get super thick. Anyways, do our best to just hammer through it. And again, this is the leather that probably no one else would tackle because it's so thick in some areas. The way it was tanned, basically, there's some areas that are super thin, and there's some areas that are like super thick. Anyways, that is a challenge, but a challenge I'm willing to tackle. So here we are gonna basically get the collar set up. What I do is to avoid thickness and still achieve nice corners is I will glue and roll, which you'll see me do here shortly. Basically, we're gonna roll this over and then we're gonna top stitch it and then trim off the excess, which you will see here shortly. Anyways, that being said, here we go. Also, you will notice I've been jumping to my single needle Juki quite a bit. Not as much as usual, just because I save that for more like technical stuff like zippers that just require a little more precision. It is tricky because it does not like to sew over the thick areas, but a little bit finessing, you can make it work. So no further discussion, here we go. But yeah, this leather has been very tricky. Looks super cool, love the way it looks, but I don't think I would do this again. Just breaking needles is not fun and gets very discouraging. And I think like when you're learning how to sew, most important thing is like wins, you know? Like you have to, getting through something and being excited about it, I think is the most important thing in the beginning of sewing. Versus like not being able to accomplish what you set out to do, like you're just not gonna wanna sew and it's gonna seem impossible. So finding like leather thickness that's like friendly for your machine is probably my best advice. So that being said, lambskin, super easy. It's very, very thin, very friendly, especially for like a Juki single needle. You can do majority of all of it on a Juki single needle. More common machine than this Adler here.